So, great words. Hello everyone. Welcome to another installment as people, sponsors getting in the way between you and the lunch. And so I'm trying to make this reasonably short. We're very glad to be able to sponsor the LibreOffice conference, which also gives us the opportunity to say a few words about the company that we're working for, which is CIB. We're here with the part of the team, and I will get to that in a moment. Thanks to all of you for attending. Thanks especially to all the organizers. Great team here, great location, great place. Very, very happy. And I'm definitely not here for the last time. So, with that out of the way, for those of you who know CIB, what are we? We are a medium-sized German company with offices in Europe and a number of places. You see that on the map. Pretty strong with investment. LibreOffice is just part of the business. Of course, very important to me and my team. But CIB does lots of other things as well. It's all around documents. So the core of the business, the core of the company, it's a virtual company, and it's about input, output, and throughput. It's about documents, and naturally LibreOffice is an important piece of the puzzle there. It's interesting, I like this color. It's even better than the white it's supposed to be. I don't know if it's nice and calming, wonderful blue. That's a number of keywords that the CIB products are standing for. So LibreOffice is part of this tool chain that they're using. And the initial reason for CIB interested in LibreOffice was for internal use. Wonderful part of the puzzle that fit in, that's used internally for a number of products. And as a second step, this knowledge and this team and the products and all that around that, we thought, well, we can of course offer that to external customers, we can offer the consultancy business, we can offer products as well. So that's what we did. But that's the reason why this. The setups here. So, LibreOffice is part of the overall strategy of the company. OEX is part of the overall strategy, so it's very important to us. And it also helps, of course, to have external business to keep the team busy. So, that's essentially the summary of what I just said. So, this is just for when you see the slides. Let's stick to that. And that's another view on the four mantras and LibreOffice is all four larger areas of the tool chain. LibreOffice is part of that. And since we're using that for our business, of course, we're looking into doing that professionally. So it can come to us, LibreOffice served, maintained, fixed, migrated to, and trained for professionally. Right. Perhaps another word on this whole tool chain topic. So, CIB is vertical. Like most of what we do is like a very special solution for very special customers, and it's all the way from top to bottom when we're doing that. And LibreOffice is really horizontal, so we use that for lots of use cases. So what we're doing for CIB internally, and very specific intersection of those two orientations that we're using. Using that opportunity, using that team that we've built over the years to offer that
system.
Great, which gets us to what we're offering, and that LibreOffice, which is presumably what we're most interested in. Let me introduce the team. First and foremost, some of them are here, we'll get to that in a moment. So we have a chunk of code developers, all over the code, code base, some of them are certified. Even we have a number of macro and extension experts. Have a migration training experience, vendor support here, active support in the community. Like to mention and stress that not only are we sponsoring the Procure Foundation's AD member, but we're also, for example, part of the OASIS. We have a technical committee and working on future versions and maintaining existing versions for the AD. Development team, that's the guys and girls we're working with some names there, some commit statistics from the past year. So there's lots of volunteer contribution, and that's essentially the local beyond drowning out the companies that are contributing to the office, and we are a decent chunk of that contribution to the programs. Special slide comes up. So basically, we got some support that, especially for migration planning and also for marketing. You might have noticed some changes. So suddenly became more outspoken in blogs and on social media. I'm very happy that Molina joined the team in June. It makes a tremendous difference. I'm very glad that she's around. She's here as well, so probably not too surprising that we have a support channel, we have a free offering for support, for any user support, that you can give us your documents you might not want to put up on the public bug tracker, and we start helping them, and we also fixing of the long-term support for trainings and migrations. So that's all the value chain and the offerings that we sell in our new office. And just put that up here as well. So there's a number of things that we're doing that I think helps around the ecosystem. So that's an investment we're making with the Document Foundation, but also in other areas, OASIS, PDF Association, also OCA, Sports Business Alliance, which is a German-speaking lobbying organization furthering the use and dissemination of open source, also creating the deal and the regulatory frameworks to make open source use more wider and widespread. And well, if you partner with us, or if you buy a lot of things from us, of course, part of that goes into those sponsorships. That's the support page, so that's the free support offering that we're giving. That's right now, it's still to do it as a management conversion. You might just want to expand that to Italian. It's live, I'm sorry, it's already. This slide is already live in Italian. And that's a number of just the existing customers. Not all of them are using the process yet. So, not to go any further with the sales talk, something that might impact most of you is four projects that we did in the past year. And I think it will have some impact on LibreOffice and what you can use in these versions. First of all, that's still work in progress. Rather massive rework of writer change. change tracking. So who has never used vital change tracking? But it's not very many people. So everybody else has used it. And so you might have, when you're an extensive user of that, you might have seen this dialog. So I think that the threshold is more than 250 changes. When you have more than that, this dialog writer strongly suggests you to not hide the changes, but to show them all. Because if you don't, it's going to be extra slow, extra buggy. And that's not very nice, and it's also not very helpful when you want to professionally work with a change tracking. Because usually what you want to see is not the final, that's not the final version, and not all the changes somebody has deleted 2 months ago. Long story short, I'm very happy that security funding is a very important keyword. It has been a festering issue since, I don't know, 20 years, something like that. It's ongoing. We hope to have that for Google 6.2, which is due in February next year. Part of that is already in 6.1, but it's not live, so we need to play with that. The second milestone is just landed in master, so when you have a very recent master and you switch on experimental mode, then you can use this new thing and play with it and fun talks. So yeah, again, thanks to the community, thanks to Michael, who's right here, if you want to talk on that, I think on Friday 10:30, about this very topic, so you can ask more questions and he was all the details. Second one, KE, who's using Linux on her desktop or laptop? Yes. Oh, it's like more than half the room, this is massive. Who's using KE? Okay, it's a generous port. But still, that's a sizable, I think, out there, a sizable population of people who are running KDE. Unfortunately, the LibreOffice support for that has been dated. And again, thanks to CTF Munich, this company has been very busy building work from Jan Marek and other people to update that and have a proper native KL5, which is name of the KDE framework, I think, version 5 and plus on that end. And that has a number of very interesting properties, including that it's the first time it's really native Qt and KDE support, so it's really using native Qt classes for a number of things. And possibly also going forward some native Qt rendering. So, it's probably not going to land, but this one is has landed in master. There's some work ongoing for accessibility support for that. So that will be in 6.2. Whether that will be enabled in TDF builds for 6.2 is a matter of debate. So if you're interested in that, you can just invite you for the ESC, which is tomorrow very early in the morning. Because that needs a baseline update for the Linux builders that TNC. There's a talk today about that, unfortunately not from Ubi, who couldn't make it this year, so I understand that it's today 1600 in this very room. Another thing, I really like this one. It's not very visible, but I think it's very important. Keep talking about that topic. So this is like LibreOffice going beyond this desktop standalone application. That is plugging LibreOffice into other pieces of software. In this case, enterprise Java applications that run on the desktop. That might say, well, that's just a step, but well, it's quite a life form for being there. And there's quite a massive amount of people running really large application frameworks, sometimes very specific, very small niches. there's quite some business there, quite some money involved. And usually, whenever there was a need for doing any rich editing, people were either using something that was a bit lacking in terms of features or working on some profits. And with the Java driver functionality around LibreOffice and the work that we did there, and also tons and tons of bug fixing around Vimeo to make that not that log. There's now two independent customers of ours that use that in such an integrated workflow application. So the screenshot that we might discuss the writer, there's also the Eclipse Java. And first and last but not least, again, this is funded about equally from City of Munich and German Federal Computer Security Agency, which is all around digital signatures and digital encryption and workflows around that. So getting document workflows away from the paper-based workflow where you sign something into the digital realm. And there will be a talk today at 3:30 about that. So this is like talking about a free software stack which you can do this digital workflows, like the equivalent of the paper-based workflows with free software. And LibreOffice is a big part of that, and City of Munich, for example, funded this signature line things with like a PDF, a literal signature in a document, and it's just what it's signed, and it's actually signed, digitally signed, and also visually signed. And the BSI funded some OpenPGP support. I talked about last year already, but it's now finished, it's now all available with 6.1. So we will be talking about that. You cut me off if I'm running out of time, will you? Okay. Great. So the more of we're doing concretely for LibreOffice. This is just one slide, which is a collection of all the things that CLE is doing, some numbers there. So as I said, there's a spoken TDF, it's an ID member. We're funding two people on the TDF board who are working for CLE. We do tons of mentoring and community work, also with some code yet inside of that, and mentoring some of that since many, many years. And I'm also the concrete work doing a few cycles, helping and supporting, mentoring. Venues from AWS over to IRC over to AdFest and other things. And just to notice that 2 out of 5 code reviewers for CLE, that's more than 3,000 code reviews a year. And those bug fixes, some of them you find in Germany, these documents were confidential. So that's the tune of 400 bug fixes in a year, 85k lines of code touched with comments from us. Oasis, very important, so we have 3 of our employees at the FTC, more than 70 contributions to the upcoming OBF.3 co-running. Cosmin, we talk about that in the OBF State of the Union talk. Which is a diamond in the month and pushing towards OEF number 3. And of course, as I said, also the environment alliance, the whole work is mostly Germany, but simply because Germany is such a large part of, or such a heavyweight in the European Union, everything that happens in Germany potentially has impact on the wider European level. So, that's where you're giving us, that's where half of them goes through. Great, so that's almost all I have to say. Just want to finish. finished with that one, that's very important. I should forget that. So you all had some gray bag inside your green bag. Did you look inside already? You should, because there's two things inside. There's one color leaflet, one other, one conscious state.
That's all fair. No one has looked inside. No,
look inside, there's a little red postcard. Yes, that one. And there's an instruction on that postcard to what you should do. So you just install a very, very nice free app. It's also the same thing, it's pretty nice. And you said not every day, but it's every week. So you can scan it, you can just get a picture of the document. That's a very nice feature as well, just getting it, even if it's on a front surface or it's completely even. So all crop that, so it's like if you don't have a scanner, you want to try it out. And also if you want to win some very nice prizes, it's a large part of that of free software, but not everything, so it's not unfortunately for 10 minutes, it's not an F drop in. But it's on the Play Store, and it's also in the iOS App Store. So it's running on open source, so it's exclusively open source. Great, so we've got. If you want to participate in the raffle, then you should be try that or ask one of your friends or co-workers to try that. Scan the QR code and we'll know if you want something else or maybe not. Anyway, install the app and give us a new app that you might not have heard. Okay, but let's finish that and the list of talks that we're having over the course of the next 3 days. Yes, that's good. And that's for team members that are here for this conference. This is Marina, somebody in the front. This is Armin, somewhere there in the middle, next to Niklas. And this is Michael Stahl sitting all the way to the back. So go to the guys. You might recognize them. I think most of them will. Some stage where those red t-shirts with this Libre Office Conference CID logo. Yeah, we'd be happy to talk with that. I wish you a wonderful conference, lots of good talks, good experience, lots of fun. Thanks again to the organizers. Good job.